We had a big lunch today at someone's home and we wanted to basically get a taste of Chennai's idli dosai vadai.
Right.
Run plate.
Two plate idli
vadai. Idli vadai first.
Ippo oru coffee saapadu.
First coffee.
This is the sort of idli that you probably need to
dunk into the sambar quite generously.
That onion chutney is delicious.
Very nice.
This is a dosai that's roasted crisp. In fact, I can't even lift it because even as I lift it, that dosai is breaking with a crispy crackle.
Hi folks, hope you're doing well. We are in Chennai. We just got here yesterday in Chennai to just chill out a bit. We had a big lunch today at someone's home and we wanted to basically get a taste of Chennai's idli dosai vadai.
Right.
And somebody told us you have to check out Sangeeta, and that's where we are headed. Sangeeta on Nungambakkam. So this is a very short sort of a visit, just here to just take a bit of a break. We thought instead of taking a break in Bengaluru, checking into a hotel there and doing a staycation, we said let's drive out a bit and also meet some people. Of course, the weather here is
hot.
Quite a change from Namma Bengaluru.
Complete 180 degrees.
180 degree change, but you know, it's nice to sweat once in a while.
Yeah.
I think Chennai is another place where there's so much food.
Yeah.
People love their food.
Correct.
And I would like to explore more of Chennai in times to come.
Yeah. And people have recommended few places, right? So maybe, you know, we should venture into some of those places, like in some Tamil Nadu, Tanjavur, Tiruchi, you know, those places.
Yes, but I think we'll make a beginning with Chennai.
Yeah.
So this, of course, is a short visit. But don't be surprised if you see us in Chennai shooting episodes of Gourmet on the Road. For now, let's get a taste of, what do you call tiffin in Tamil? What do you say if you want to have evening snacks?
Palahara, evening palahara.
Okay, right now we're just going to savor some
palagaram.
Palagaram.
Palagaram, palaharam, whatever.
Palaharam, palagaram. At Sangeeta. Can we sit? Look at
this.
Idli, adu vada, bonda, puri, pongal, khichdi, dosa, chapati, parotha.
You know, Chennai famous Sangeeta, this one?
Almost 40 branches.
40 branches?
Abroad almost 20, almost 60 branches.
60 branches?
Yeah.
So when people say go to Sangeeta Chennai, this is the one they say?
Yeah, this is the group.
This is the group. Run plate.
Two plate idli.
Idli vadai first.
I think when it comes to the tiffin meals, I think it is Sangeeta's. So I think they are probably the most popular. So on the map when I saw it said Apurva Sangeeta. So I was a little confused whether this was the real Sangeeta or not, but I'm told it is. And I'm told all of Chennai, if they want to have dosai idli.
When we entered Chennai yesterday, actually we had coffee and medu bonda in Chennai.
Correct.
That's Sangeeta only.
That's right. Yesterday on our way in, on the highway, there was a time when we really wanted coffee and we were looking for coffee, couldn't find. So we started searching all the way from Sri Perambudur. And then finally, I think about 20 odd kilometers outside Chennai, we found a Sangeeta where we had some good coffee and also the
medu bonda.
The medu bonda. And I think we should have some more of that today. So I want to have today the idli, the vadai, the dosai, and the medu gonda.
There's so many things they have. Mushroom 65, paneer 65, chili paratha.
I guess for those in Chennai, they probably want to have some change. They want to have something different, not just the...
Yeah, just the dosai.
So are you happy that you came to Chennai?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Today is the most memorable, one of the most memorable days of my life, because I met Prabhu Ganeshan. That's the greatest Tamil star, Sivaji Ganeshan's son. We had a meal there. What a fabulous experience, and they're so humble. The really, the humility of those people, right? Really, you know?
That's true.
It's amazing. It's amazing how, you know, people are so grounded and so humble, you know?
What led to this was so amazing, because I think a couple of months ago I received a call from him mentioning that he follows the show, and I was quite humbled to receive that. And then when he learned that I was in Chennai, he said, "You must come over for a meal," and that's what happened today. We had a big meal and got to meet the family. It was very nice, very special. I've got some pictures up on Instagram. If you follow me on Instagram, you've seen it already, but if not, I'll probably put a couple of pictures here. But yeah, that was nice. So since we had a big brunch of sorts there, we thought we'll have an easy, light sort of evening supper. And therefore this palahara.
Yeah, palahara.
The pala, what does pala mean?
Snacks, they say palahara.
Yeah.
Palaharam, they say palaharam, they say.
Therefore this light palahara of sorts. But it's going to be a little more than light with the idli, vadai, dosai, and also something else. How's it? Yeah. My first Chennai idli on this visit. I think this is an idli that certainly has some weight.
Yeah.
Right? I think this is the sort of idli that you probably need to dunk into the sambar quite generously. And I think that's how you enjoy this idli, you know. So I think this is an idli that you need to soften a bit with the sambar, huh? I found the idli a little firm. But then I guess some idlis are the sort where you give it a nice bath almost in that sambar.
Sambar is excellent.
Yeah.
Very nice.
You want that sambar to seep into every pore of that idli. And I think that's how you best savor this idli. I'm enjoying the idli with the sambar. I haven't even gotten to the chutneys yet. How are the chutneys, sweet?
Very good.
Yeah.
Both the coconut chutney and then the tomato on each chutney.
I think they've been steamed and kept for a while. It also, I think, sometimes depends on when you visit an eatery. So I think when the eatery is the busiest and when idlis are flying out of the steamer,
that time it will be nice and fluffy.
It's evening time, early evening, so perhaps the eatery isn't as busy. But when you dunk the idlis into the sambar and you savour them, that's when that idli comes alive.
This Tamil Nadu sambar is very good. This Karnataka is also different, but this is really, you know, something.
I think the character of the sambar is very different, right? So I think you're tasting more the...
Tur dal.
There is no sweetness in a Tamil sambar, so I think it's mostly the lentils that you taste. You have a bit of that sweet acidity of the tomatoes. Then the spices, the sambar masala, I think that itself is very fragrant, you know. Well, that onion chutney is delicious.
Very nice. And the tomato onion chutney.
Kashmiri chilli, garlic.
Little jaggery, right?
Normal chili, Kashmiri chili. Color for Kashmiri chili.
Color Kashmiri chili. That chutney is delicious. How long back was this idli steam?
I think 10 minutes.
10 minutes before it came to our table, yeah.
So I think when there's more crowd, then probably it's more hotter when it comes.
Yeah. Every 5 minutes they will remove and they will put it in the hot box.
But now there is not too much crowd. I think that's always with a tiffin establishment. When you go the busiest time, that's when the idlis, the vadais are flying out of the kitchen. So I think when it comes to a Tamil idli vadai, it's also those condiments on the plate, right?
Right. And the vada is so good, you know, you're eating after 10-15 minutes later. Even now the vada is very nice and crispy.
My last soak of the idli in that sambar. So here the key is, you almost submerge the idli into the sambar. You make sure that the sambar has seeped into every pore of the idli. Almost that you reconstitute the idli, and just before it starts breaking up, place it in your mouth. That's when you best savor this idli. I'm sure when you come here during a busy time, I'm sure the idlis are hotter than the temperature at which it came to our table. Nonetheless, makes for a tasty snack. Let's retrieve some of that idli that has given itself to the sambar. I think now for that vadai. Like Shree said, the vadai still retains an element of crunch. So it's been fried earlier, it's come to my table, probably I've spent 10 minutes talking to the idli, making a conversation to the idli while the vade was sitting there forlorn, but the vade still is crisp and I just bit into some pepper.
Yeah, pepper.
Oh, nice. It's a small vadai, also started with some green chilli there. But I think the sort that will be happy to make friends with that coconut, the tenga chutney, huh? Delicious. And this chutney is quite special too. But tomato, onion, mandol, the color comes from the Kashmiri malaga, and there's also a bit of jaggery that goes into it. Yeah. Vellum.
Yeah, vellum.
Vellum also means water.
No, water means panya.
That's in Malayalam.
That's in Malayalam.
I'm getting my languages confused. Mixed up. I think that pepper is delicious. So you have that sweet acidity of the tomato, a bit of the heat that you get from that Kashmiri
Malaga,
and of course the saviness of the onions,
yeah,
and some of that vellum that gives it a nice sweetish edge.
Ghee padi dosa irukku, ghee padi masala irukku, onion rava.
I will have a regular masala dosa.
Masala and ghee padi masala.
Fantastic. This is a dosa that's roasted crisp. In fact, I can't even lift it because even as I lift it, that dosa is breaking with a crispy crackle. As you know, I love to go for my dosa right in the center. And that's what we're going to do with this dosa too. That dosa is roasted to a crisp. And there's that podi that's smeared on that dosa. Sort of dosa that greets your palate with a crisp crackle. There's some jaggery in that podi too.
Mm-hmm.
You want to taste some?
No.
Shree is happy with her
masala dosa.
Masala dosa, how is it?
Very good.
Yeah.
You
want
to try some?
Can I?
Please.
Get some dosa, get some of that palya. I'm going to get a bit of that chilli. The consistency of the palya is soft and
yeah. The
palya is creamy, almost mashed in. And then you've got the onion, the vengayam and some chilli there. Only once you taste the ghee podi, that is a little difficult to resist. So why don't you taste a bit of this, just to get a sense. Get a big piece.
You know, I have to finish mine also.
Nice. There's plenty of the podi that I am tasting in that dosa. and there's plenty of the ghee that I can taste. That is also on my fingers. I think in Chennai they like the dosa crisp, isn't it? But I'm quite enjoying this. Of course, because it's roasted crisp, it's also the sort of dosa that breaks up into little pieces that you bring together with some of that potato masala and introduce perhaps to your chutney. This part of the dosa isn't too crisp, so it's allowing me to scoop up that potato stuffing.
The masala. With some dignity. I think the chutneys are quite special.
Freshly made.
Yeah, the chutney is absolutely fresh. Delicious.
They must have grated now and then, you know, freshly, you know, grated coconut chutney.
And then of course the sambar. You can taste some of the esophytida as well in that sambar.
Yeah, huh? For sure.
And I think the size of this dosa is very big, huh?
Yeah, very big, huh?
Especially if you've eaten the idli, two idlis, one vada.
No, after eating two idli, one vada, and then one masala dosa, I'm like stuffed. I don't want to eat anything.
What about the medu bonda? You can have one.
I'm done.
Masala here also has some peas. So it provides a bit of a soft pop every now and then. This is the sort of dosa that you enjoy with the chutneys and also the sambar. There's plenty of onions in that masala.
Till you finish the dosa, you know, you have some potato palya. Normally what happens, right, sometimes, you know, you finish the 3/4 of the dosa and then you run out of potato palya. Whereas in this, till the, in the last bite, you have the palya left.
That's right. So out here, I'm probably in the last 1/3 of my dosa, but I still have that palya. Of course, my dosa is a bit of a mess as it has disintegrated, but there's still plenty of the masala that you're tasting almost with every scoop of the dosa. I must remember that I'm in Tamil Nadu, so it's not dosa. It's not dosa.
Dosai.
It's not dosa, it's a dosai.
D-O-S-A-I. Normally people are saying it's dosa podu. I mean, if they're saying at home and all, you know, like, you can dosa podu, food dosa podu, dosa dan solo. Tamilian, the way of saying is dosai. Like how in Karnataka they say dosa, in Telugu they say dosa.
I'm relishing that dosai with the chutney. The other thing that I find in this dosa, it's one level through and through. Whereas in a dosa in Karnataka, you have certain parts which are thick, certain parts which are crispy. But I think in the dosa that I'm tasting here, the dosai that I'm tasting here, it's basically, I think when they ladle that dosa batter on the pan, on the tawa, they basically ladle it to one level. So it's crisp all the way through. Right? That's what it is. And if you probably want it soft, it'll be soft almost all the way through. There's no concentric rounds of thick and thin, of soft and crisp. So this is a dosa. From a texture perspective, at least this one that I'm tasting is quite uniform all the way through. The best part here are the chutneys, and coconut chutney is fresh. And the sambar. That's a sort of sambar that one is happy to savor all by itself with some of that curry leaf. Karepile.
Karepile.
And the onion is what?
Vengayam.
And the vengayam. And also some of the takali, the tomato. You can taste the nourishment of the lentils in that sambar. Somebody said we should taste the Mysore bonda.
I'm so stuffed.
Rumba suda irka. Oh, this is hot. This is really, really hot. I think it's just come off the oil. You can barely hold it. I think what I really like about
plates here is the fact that you've got two chutneys and then the sambar. We're playing with different flavors, so whether it's the fresh flavors of the coconut, the chutneys are excellent. I think that coconut is fresh. And like Sri said, it's almost as if somebody has just grated the coconut and put that chutney together. And then the flavors of that tomato onion chutney is delicious. And the sambar, brilliant. Mysore Bonda. You can see some steam escape from that bonda. That's how hot, sued this bonda is. I love the green chilies in there. There's some pepper there somewhere.
Peppercorns.
Some peppercorns, whole peppercorns. The batter for this is the same as the batter for the medu vadai.
Right.
But this is, of course, made into a dumpling and then deep fried.
That's why it's called a Mysore bonda.
That's why it's called a Mysore bonda. It's crisp on the outside and quite airy, almost cloud-like on the inside. And you go crunch, crunch, crunch from the first bite till the last. I can also taste some cumin in there somewhere. Oh, lovely. You want to scoop it up with some of that chutney. I think if you come to Sangeeta, you should not leave without tasting that Mysore bonda. The dosa was very nice. The idli was fine. I wish it was hotter, straight off the steamer. The vadai was good, but this, to me, is a dish that I will remember long after I have left Sangeeta restaurant. It's a simple dumpling at the end of the day, right? It's a simple, it's batter that's deep fried. But what's nice here is both the texture and the flavor. So the texture, for instance, you have to eat it sooda to appreciate it, is that crisp crunchiness on the outside. So when you bite into it, when you bite on it, you got that soft crunch from the first bite to the last. And then it's airy, cloud-like inside, and then the various flavors that you taste. So once in a while you bite into a chili, you know, so that has its spice. Once in a while you bite into the peppercorn, so that has a certain warmth. Then you bite into a cumin, so that has that delicious aroma that wafts through your mouth. So that is the flavors that's contained within this Mysore bonda. And then the various flavors that you taste as you introduce this bonda to the other players on your plate, whether it's that coconut chutney, the tomato onion chutney, or the sambar. And that's what I'm going to do next. Dunk the bonda in that sambar. Almost give it a luxurious soak of sorts. And what's nice here is that the bonda readily drinks up all the sambar inside, but on the outside it still maintains its crunchy texture. I think what will also be nice with this is a nice cup of coffee. Just the way I like my coffee. The coffee is strong, hot, and I think it will make for a interesting contrast to that bonda that started with quite a bit of the chili. The pachu melaga, the green chili. I think this is the Chennai equivalent of your chai and pakoda. So this is the coffee and the bonda, the Mysore bonda.
My masala dosa was good and vada was good.
The idli vada was also good. For me, the favorite was the Mysore bonda.
I'm sure.
Then followed by the dosai. And then the vada and then the idli. What I really loved
the common denominator through all of that was the sambar and the chutneys. I think they were delicious, absolutely delicious. So if you're in Chennai and you want to savor some Chennai style breakfast or evening snacks, definitely check out Sangeeta. I'm told there are about 40 odd branches all over Tamil Nadu, but we are on the one on Nungambakkam Road. So until the next time, take care, stay safe. Bye-bye.